Okay, I am sorry because of the internet disconnection. We are having this problem at Lakana. I'm sorry for that. So we were talking about the moderate level of autonomy at the for the factory directors in Russia. So if you are a factory director in any enterprise, normally you won't be given much authority. Okay, there are certain decisions, there are certain things on which you have certain liberty. And among those certain liberty things or topics are the main agenda points, or the moderate, at a moderate level are these points. You can negotiate with the government or supervisory branch ministry about annual product targets, whatever the target you have been given to achieve for an annual purpose, or whatever material you would be needing to produce those units, whatever you are asked for, or financial resources, how much money you have been given, or how much money you would be needing to achieve the target, the production target, or how many people, human resources, how many people you need to be allocated, or you need to have, or how many people are going to retire this year, and how many more people you want to hire. So you need to negotiate with the branch ministry, who whatever is actually responsible for the supervisory for your production area or production unit. The second point is the disposition of unused buildings. If you are having, if your company or your factory or your enterprise is having certain buildings or material resources that are not used, so what you can do with those buildings, you can decide about those. You have certain disposition, but all you need to have an approval from the supervisory branch ministry. You can dispose of them, you can use them if you want to. If, say, for instance, if you are having a godown, a building for a godown, you can use that godown for your purpose, for your manufacturing purpose, for the storing of certain material if you want to store them. If you have material that is not used, you can use those material. You have certain liberty on that thing. Moving forward, the minor realignments of fixed products or product mix. You can realign different product mix. You can create mix by your own self. You have certain liberty on that. Okay, moving forward, procurement. You can procure the supplementary resources. In order to produce main product, you need certain supplementary resources. Therefore, you can procure them, because we have sometimes, we are living in a dynamic world. Therefore, we have many unforeseen, unplanned contingencies. Therefore, in order to meet those unforeseen or unplanned contingencies, we need the factory director's authority to procure those resources if you need to achieve your target. Such as late deliveries for the supplies. If you didn't get the supplies on time, you can think about procuring supplies from any other source or any other supplier. The production and sale of limited goods and services beyond the commitment of official plan. Okay, you can actually produce more if you want, or if you have the capacity to produce more goods and services apart from the official plan commitment. Whatever the commitment you get with your supervisory branch ministry, you can produce more if you want to, or if you want to sell a certain limited number of goods or units or services to that official commitment, you have certain authority, because there are always contingencies. Therefore, on those contingencies, the factory director has certain authority. Moving forward, the disposition of enterprise funds. If you are having certain funds is retained earnings, where you can use those enterprise retained earnings. You can use them for the special bonuses or social expenditure, or using for recreational activities and housing for the employees working in the company or enterprise. You can use those funds, whatever the portion has been given to you, to your company or your enterprise. Moving forward to dismissals and layoffs. Yes, factory directors has a moderate autonomy to lay off any of the employee if they want to, or dismiss any employee if they want to. Moving forward to the next point, that is high autonomy areas. Now, what are those areas on which the factory director has complete autonomy or high autonomy? These are the day-to-day scheduling. These are the operational areas. How you are going to do your work within the organization, within the enterprise. So this is your domain. There won't be any interference from the Communist Party or from the higher bureaucrat inside your operation domain. You can coordinate your task because it's your responsibility to achieve the target. And how you are achieving the target, that is your responsibility. And the top management or the top bureaucratic culture or politicians are not going to intervene or interfere into your operations. So resources, how much resources used, where should they should be used, in what capacity they should be used, what effort level should be put into achieving something, it's your authority. You can recruit and hire your employees by your own self. You have complete authority over there. But we were talking about in the very first slide when we were talking about these autonomy area functions of the factory directors, we said that company or enterprise has limited authority over the recruitment of the top notch directors or the deputies of the directors, because the government is going to appoint those deputies and directors. Okay, moving forward, you are responsible. You have complete authority over the employee trainings and development. Moving forward towards the management functions, the very first function of Soviet management function was planning. Now here you have been given a comparison between the free enterprise management system that you have studied from BBA to principles of management, HRM, whatever the courses you have translated to the management. And on the other side, you have been told about the former Soviet Union management, how the planning used to be done in Soviet Union. Basically, why we are studying Soviet or socialist management is we are telling you the failures of why the socialism failed or why socialist management failed in Soviet Union, and why they actually adopted the mixed economy, why they came to capitalist environment or capitalism. So here, let's talk about the planning. So generally, as we have studied that in free enterprises, mostly in European or Western countries, they have high art managerial autonomy in regard of what to produce, how to produce, how much to produce, when to produce. So all the WH words, all the question words, they have all the authority. Whereas in Soviet Union or former Soviet Union management, the managers usually have limited authority. They cannot determine by themselves what to produce, how to produce, when to produce, and how much quantity they have to produce, and who will be responsible for producing all those goods and services or whatever that thing is. Here, the provincial production plans are developed for each province, for each division, for each district. And then they are negotiated and reconciled every year, annually, by every supervisory branch ministry. So you are actually centrally controlled by these ministries. These ministries were the responsible for the production within the production unit or the factory. Therefore, it was these ministries who were actually responsible for the overall planning purposes. Moving forward, the subsequent adjustments are or were possible because Soviet managers has to think about unforeseen contingencies. The contingency variable or the variable nature of the situations you have to think about. You can change the priorities, you can delay certain deliveries, or if you receive certain goods lately as your supplies or as your raw materials, there is a possibility that you might delay the production. Moving forward, planning influence. Generally, in free enterprise, what happens? The plans and plannings are influenced directly by the stakeholders or indirectly by the stakeholders. Now, who are the stakeholders? It is we, that is the employee, shareholders, maybe the stakeholders, the creditors, suppliers, environmentalists, government, communities, the people working inside directly or indirectly, they are the influencers of the overall planning. But when it comes to the former Soviet Union or socialist management, the overall planning and plan coordinations are done by Ministry of Technocrats or the Communist Party itself. Therefore, there is no influence from the outside apart from only political and technocrats. Nominal consultation is done with the employees and the community officials. You can have a say in the decisions about in the enterprise, but you are given nominal importance in those decisions. The Communist Party is the responsible, ultimate responsible, ultimately monitors its social, political, ideological interests in every enterprise. Therefore, it is the Communist Party that actually controls, plans everything. Moving forward, normally we have studied that in free enterprises in the United States or in Western countries or Western Europe, attention to strategic planning is always more important. For instance, continual adjustments of the firm to evolving market opportunities. You can change your planning because the dynamic world is changing, market is evolving, people, trends are changing, competition is actually compelling you to change. Our micro environment is influencing your planning. Whereas in Soviet Union or socialist management, there is no need for enterprise level strategic planning because here in socialist management, overall government is responsible for the entire country. They don't have any competition. They don't care about the micro environment changes. They don't care about the trends because the government itself is a trendsetter. Enterprises on year-to-year production plans and day-to-day operations are planned. Therefore, more emphasis is on given on year-to-year production. They don't care about anything else. Generally, they have this one central body, central government planning office, that is the Federal Sports Plan, that is overall responsible for supervisory of the planning domain. So you cannot actually think about anything else, but to produce whatever target you have been given for a certain period. We stop here. We shall start with our new function, that is organizing. That would be the part 2.4, I guess, if I'm not wrong. So let's conclude. We shall meet in our next portion. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.